They endured what's been described as the worst atrocities of World War II, but the thousands of Aussie soldiers killed in Borneo still have not been given the recognition they deserve. Few have even heard of the Sandakan death marches. Now there's a push to remember the massacre, like we do Gallipoli and Kokoda. Tonight, Georgie Glover reports from Borneo.
If it wasn't for these brave men, all of these men would have been forgotten. Their story is so awful, it's taken generations to tell. When the Australian government first heard what had happened to these soldiers, it was so horrendous, it was kept secret from their families and shielded from the whole country.
Death rate was 99.75%.
Almost 2,500 Allied soldiers became prisoners of war in Borneo in 1942. By the end of the war, just six were left alive, and only because they escaped. The rest were starved, beaten, tortured and butchered by their Japanese captors.
None of my friends came back. They were all Harry Longley, Joey Crone. Poor old Dobbo.
Billy Young is the only soldier alive today who witnessed the horror of Sandakan.
Well, their cruelty was something, nothing else, something unbelievable to us Western people. You see people being killed, just bashed and killed just for no reason at all.
Before long, our once strapping Aussie soldiers were skeletal thin and as sick as could be. And in that state, they were forced to march through the near impenetrable jungle for weeks on end from Sandakan to Renau, 250 kilometres away. It was a death march. Until very recently, the dense jungle concealed the track, but today, much like Kokoda, you can finally follow in the footsteps of these doomed soldiers. A journey Billy Young and historian Lynette Silver encourage every Aussie to trace and remember.
Borneo is a mystery to most people, let alone death marches. It should be up there with Gallipoli and El Alamein and Kokoda, all those places that are on everyone's lips, because it was Australia's worst disaster from the Second World War.
They despair that one of Australia's worst military disasters is virtually unheard of.
On the 15th of August 1945, Private Johnny Skinner woke up to find that he was the only prisoner of war left alive. He was marched over here, blindfolded and beheaded. 5 hours later, Japan surrendered.
If this story gets lost, then the suffering and the heroism of the people who were there is of no account. Once you lose a story, it's lost forever.
But it's not too late to honour them. Georgie Glover, 10 News.